If you want even more details about this topic, check out the link below to go to the lesson page for this video on programmingelectronics.com. You'll find supporting material like the written lesson, a quiz to test if you understand the topic, supporting code, and more. Let's say you're building a project using Arduino, and you have an event that you want to have happen every so often. Maybe every 3 minutes you want a servo motor to move, or maybe every 20 seconds you want to update a web server with the most current sensor reading. How do you create timed events like this with Arduino? That's exactly the objective of this series of lessons, that by the end, you'll be able to program repetitive timed events using Arduino. Now, in the last lesson, we talked about the delay function and some of the features of the delay function. So if you haven't had a chance yet to look at the previous two videos, you should go and check them out after this is over. So in this lesson, what we're going to do is identify when using the delay function really makes sense, and also times when you should consider an alternate route, dumping delay, and instead using something like the millis function for timing events. Specifically, in this lesson, we'll cover the simple timed event, the not so simple timed event, or as I like to call it, the thing you think ought to be simple but just isn't. And finally, we'll talk about a variant of the ancient Mayan calendar, which is becoming popular in small pockets of Polynesia. Okay, let's get started. So we are going on a learning journey, and our final destination is to be able to program timed repetitive events with Arduino. In the first lesson of the series, we talked about the millis function and some of the things to keep an eye on when using it. In the second lesson, we talked about tight loops and blocking code, and we said that the delay function decreases the tightness of a loop and also acts as blocking code. So to continue on this learning journey, I want you to imagine for a second that you're throwing a party. Actually, me and you, we're throwing a party together. It's gonna be awesome. We've got tiki torches, we're gonna have a pig on a spit, a magician, and we've even contracted a live Guns N' Roses cover band. Oh, it's gonna be sweet. I can't wait. Now, to welcome the guests at the door, we've decided to get a life-size cardboard cutout of you that we're gonna put right at the front door. And to make it more fun, we went ahead and drilled out the eyes, and we replaced them with these oversized green LEDs to make it like more lifelike, so it looks like you're possessed by an alien. And we've taken those two LEDs and we've connected them to an Arduino board with just two simple LED circuits. So then we gotta program the Arduino. So first, before we go into the Arduino IDE, we write out our algorithm. And it's pretty simple. We just wanna turn the LEDs on. So it's one line, turn LEDs on. And we're pretty sure we're gonna need the pin mode function and the digital write function to do this. So now that we've mapped out our program, we jump into the Arduino IDE. So we've got the Arduino IDE open, I've got a blank sketch, and I'm gonna start by designating the pins where I've got the LED circuits attached. So I'll do that now. Okay, so I've declared and initialized two constants. One is for the left eye and one is for the right, pin 7 and pin 8. And I've made them constants because they're not going to change. I also went ahead and created the setup and the loop functions in here. Setup runs once and loop runs over and over and over. Now in the setup, I'm going to use the pin mode function and I'm going to set the mode for those two pins as outputs because I want a source voltage to those. So I'll do that now. Now I'm going to use the digital write function to turn the LEDs on. I only want to turn the LEDs on once, so I'm just going to stick digital write in the setup. I'll do that now. Okay, so I've used the digital write function and I have turned on both of those LED pins to high. So we upload this code to the Arduino, we step back, we take a look at your cardboard cutout and the eyes are shining bright. Hey, that looks pretty cool. But as almost always happens, as we're looking, we start to think, you know, it'd be cool if those eyes flickered. You know, it would make it more lifelike. So what we decide to do is every 100 milliseconds, we want the LEDs to turn off and then turn back on. That is, we want to create a simple, timed, repetitive event. So we pull out a piece of paper and we want to think through our algorithm one more time. We want the LED to be on for 100 milliseconds, and then we want it to be off for 100 milliseconds. So really, our algorithm is still pretty easy. You know, LED on, wait, LED off, wait, repeat this over and over. So to do this, we figure we can use the digital write function to turn the LED on and off, and we're already doing that, so that should be easy. And then for the wait part, we could use the delay function. And that repeat part of it, we could just take the code and put it inside the loop since we know that the loop runs over and over again. So let's go ahead and jump back into the Arduino sketch and implement this. So we're back in the Arduino IDE, and you know, this sketch is really pretty simple. Think what all we need to do is move the digital writes down to the loop, that'll repeat them and put in some delays. So I'll go ahead and do that now. Okay. So now in the loop, I've got two digital writes, and we're turning the LEDs on. We're applying high voltage to those two pins. And then we do a delay. I decided to increase that delay to 500 milliseconds, so that's half a second. And then we do another digital write. We write them low so the LEDs would turn off, and then we wait 500 milliseconds so that we can see that those LEDs are off. So it turns them on, we wait, turns them off, we wait. So we go ahead, we upload this sketch to the Arduino board. We step back and we're like, oh, this is fantastic. This is exactly what we've wanted. We have created a simple, timed, repetitive events. That's right, those eyes are flickering. It looks like you're possessed by an alien. This is exactly what we wanted. So yay for the delay function. This is perfect. But you know, as often happens, we're sitting back looking at the project and we think, you know, it'd be neat if we had like an effect where the left and the right eyes would they'd rapidly turn on and off. So we go ahead and we pull that piece of paper out and we update our algorithm. So now we've got the LED on, we're gonna wait 500 milliseconds, we'll turn it off, we'll wait 500 milliseconds, and then we wanna do this LED eye alternating thing for like, we'll do it for a second long, but we'll have them blink on and off really quick. And then we just wanna repeat that over and over. So to do this, we figure all we really have to do is add a for loop. And then we'll alternately write high and low voltages to each of those pins that control the LEDs. So we go back into the Arduino IDE and we go ahead and add the for loop. So I come to the bottom of the loop, and now what I want to do is add this for loop. So I'll go ahead and do that. So now we've got a for loop, and for 10 iterations, we turn the left LED on and then the right LED off. We wait 10 milliseconds, and then we switch the high and low, and then we do another delay. So we upload the code, step back, look at it, and we say, oh, that's so cool. You know, it's like your eyes blink, and then it does this cool like LED flicker things. This is exactly what we wanted. Now we have two timed repetitive events. Each one happens one after the other. Man, this delay function is working great. I don't know why everybody gives it so much grief. But as you know how things go, we start to think, you know, this eye flash thing is so cool. Why don't we ditch that whole first blinking part and just have the eyes flash like alternating? And you know what would be cool? In addition to the eyes blinking, let's cut off your arm at the elbow. We'll connect a servo motor, and then we'll get like some alien arm and we'll put it in its place and we'll have the alien arm wave back and forth. Now that would be pretty cool. So we grab our piece of paper and we write our algorithm, and it looks something like this. So we've got the LEDs alternating back and forth for 1 second, and then we've got the alien arm waving back and forth, and we just want to repeat that. But we start to have this sneaky feeling that something isn't quite right. But you know, we say heck with the sneaky feeling. We go into the Arduino IDE and we're gonna write some code and we'll get our servo to sweep back and forth. So we jump into the Arduino IDE, and the first thing we do is include the servo library. Then we create a servo object, and we also create a variable that will hold the position of the servo. Then we attach the servo to pin 9. And then down in the loop, we said we didn't care about the blinking code anymore because we like the alternating LED eye effect better. So we get rid of that code. And after this for loop, what we're going to do is add a for loop that's going to move the position of that servo, and it's going to sweep the servo left and right. And you know, if you're not familiar with using servos, don't sweat the servo code too much. We're really just trying to use this example to show you some of the issues we run into with delay. But so right now I'm going to go ahead and use two for loops to move that servo back and forth. So we upload the code, and now that sneaky feeling we had, it becomes very apparent. Because what we have is the LED effect flickering, and then the hand waves, and then the LED flickers, and then the hand waves. So instead of having two events that overlap in time, we've got two events, one happens, and then the other. That is, we want the hand to wave while the LEDs are blinking. So this is a problem. Kind of gone are the good old days of one thing happening after the other. Now we have two overlapping timed events, and it kind of seems like delay is part of the issue. And it really is, because that delay is blocking the other code from running. Now what we could do is try putting the servo code, that for loop, at the top of the loop too, so we'd have it at the top and the bottom, but all that would do would get the servo kind of waving two times in a row, but then we'd have the LEDs blink, and then the servo would wave two times in a row, so that really doesn't do what we're after. So this kind of stinks. It seems like delay is getting in the way of what we need to do. The delay function is blocking what we have to run. So if you have two timed events that are overlapping, that is, you want one to happen while the other is happening, then the delay function is probably not going to be your best bet. And an alternative is using the millis function. So let me say it one more time just to try to drive home the idea here. If you have two repetitive timed events and those events overlap, then you may find that using the delay function is not going to be the best solution for programming that. And you're going to want to consider an alternative like the millis function, which we will explore in following lessons. On the flip side of this, when we have two timed events and one happens after the other, then using the delay function is perfect. It's simple and it's a great solution. Now, in the next lesson, what we'll do is explore another situation where using the delay function can start to cause troubles. So I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson. Bye.